Hello friends, today we shall discuss potential energy of a single charge and two charges in an external electric field. In a previous class, we have discussed potential energy of a single charge in the absence of electric field is equal to zero and the potential energy of two charges in the absence of external electric field is K Q1 Q2 upon R, where R is the distance between two charges. And today we discuss electrostatic potential energy of a single charge and two charges in the presence of external electric field. So first, electric potential energy of a single charge in an external electric field. Consider uniform electric field E, and this field, uniform field, is produced due to an unspecified charge or unknown charge. It is at far off distance, and let A be a point at which a charge to be brought against external electric field, and phi be the potential at point A. A charge Q1, Q at infinity, its potential is zero. When it is brought against external electric field, work has to be done to bring the charge Q from infinity to the point A. And this work done in bringing a charge from infinity to a point in an electric field is equal to the charge into potential at that point. Therefore, W infinity to A equal to charge into potential at A. And now, electrostatic potential energy of two charges in an external electric field E. Consider a charge Q1. It is at infinite distance from A, and electrostatic field goes on, decreases and becomes zero at a certain point. Then work done in bringing a charge Q1 from infinity to the point A against electrostatic field E is equal to charge into potential at that point. Let A and B be the two points in an electric field E, and V1 and V2 be the potentials at A and B. Then work W1 be the work done to bring a charge from infinity to the point A. Hence, W1 equal to work done from infinity to A equal to charge into potential at A. Potential at A is V1 and charge brought is Q1. Therefore, W1 equal to Q1 V1. Consider this as equation 1. Now, for charge 2, here Q1 is brought at point A. Now for charge Q2, work done in bringing a charge Q2 from infinity to the point B, it has to overcome two electrostatic forces. They are due to external electric field E and potential due to charge Q1 at B. Therefore, W2 be the work done in moving a charge from infinity to the point B, then W2 equal to charge into potential at B due to external electric field. Due to external electric field, V2 is the potential at B. And potential at B due to charge at Q1. If R12 or R12 is the distance between two points in an electric field, that is R12, then potential at B due to charge at A is KQ1 upon R. You have studied. Therefore, charge into potential at B due to external electric field E plus potential at B due to charge Q1, and that is equal to charge brought is Q2. Therefore, Q2 in the bracket, potential at B due to external field is V2 plus potential at B due to charge Q1 is KQ1 upon R12, where R12 is the distance between Q1 and Q2. Hence, W2 equal to Q2 into V2, Q2 V2 plus Q1, KQ1 into Q2 upon R12, KQ1 Q2 upon R12. Consider this as equation 2. This is the work done in bringing a charge from infinity to the point B against two electrostatic repulsive forces due to Q1 and due to external electric field. Therefore, net work done, total work done in assembling two charges Q1 and Q2 at a distance R12 is W1 plus W2. And here W1, it is the work done in bringing a charge Q1 from infinity to the point A, and W2 is the total work done due to external, against the external electric field and against field due to charge Q1. That is Q1 V1 plus Q2 V2 plus KQ1 Q2 upon R12. This work done in assembling these charges Q1 and Q2 is stored in the system as potential energy. Therefore, W is equal to potential energy of the system. Hence, U equal to Q1 V1 plus Q2 V2 plus K Q1 Q2 upon R12. And this can be illustrated by an example. Example: two charges, 7 microcoulomb and minus 2 microcoulomb, are located at minus 9, 0, 0 centimeter and plus 9, 0, 0 centimeter. Here, charges are located along the x axis, that is minus x axis and plus x axis, and y coordinate and z coordinates are 0. And you are asked to find the electrostatic potential energy of charges in the absence of external electric field. There is no external electric field. And number two, work done to separate these charges to the infinite distance. And number three, potential energy of the system of these two charges in an external electric field of field strength E equal to A of 1 upon R square, where A is charge density, that is 9 into 10 raised to 5 coulomb per meter square. First, note down this problem. Pause the video and note down. Then we shall solve one by one. Number one, potential energy of charges in the absence of electric field. In the absence of electric field, potential energy U is equal to K Q1 Q2 upon R1 2. Here R1 is the distance of charge Q1 from the origin, and R2 is the distance of the point charge minus 2 microcoulomb from the origin, that is minus 9 centimeter and plus 9 centimeter. Therefore, distance between 7 microcoulomb and minus 2 microcoulomb is R1 plus R2, it is R12, and that is equal to, here K is constant, that is 9 into 10 to the power 9 into Q1 is 7 into 10 to the power minus 6 into minus 2 into 10 to the power minus 6 coulomb upon R12, it is the distance between these two points. This is 9 plus 9, that is equal to 18 centimeter. Convert it in meter, that is 0.18 meter. That is equal to 9 into 7. Use calculator. 9 into 7 into 2 equal to 126, and 126 upon 0.18 is equal to minus 0.7 joules. This much of work is done in bringing the charges from infinity to these points. Number two, what is the work done to separate the charges to the infinite distance? Therefore, work done to separate the charges to the infinite distance is W is equal to U2 minus U1, where U2 is the energy of these charges at infinite distance. At infinite distance, potential is zero, therefore energy is also equal to zero. Hence, U2 equal to zero minus U1 is the initial energy of these two charges when they are separated at 0.18 meter. That is equal to minus 0.7 joules, and that is equal to 0.7 joules. This much of energy is this much of work is done to separate the charges, and it is equal to the difference between the final energy and initial energy. And now, what is the energy of system of these two charges in the presence of external electric field? Suppose these charges are placed in an uniform external electric field E. Then, potential energy of system of two charges in an external electric field is given by U equal to Q1 V1 plus Q2 V2 plus potential energy due to charge Q1 R1 2 and that is equal to here V1 is related as we know that density, linear density lambda equal to Q upon L. Surface density sigma equal to Q upon area. And volume density it is rho equal to Q upon volume. And here E equal to A of 1 by R square, that is equal to 9 into 10 raised to 5 coulomb per meter square is given. Therefore, it can be written as A of Q1 upon R1 plus Q2 upon R2 plus K Q1 Q2 upon R1 2. Here A equal to 9 into 10 to the power 5. In the bracket Q1 is 7 microcoulomb. Microcoulomb is taken outside. 7 upon R1 2, that is 9 centimeter. It is equal to 9 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter or 0.09 meter. That is 0.09 minus, because Q2 equal to minus 2. 2 divided by R2 is also equal to 9 centimeter. That is equal to 0.09 meter. Plus K Q1 Q2 upon R12. We have calculated and it is equal to minus 7 minus 0.7 joule. This is the energy of two charges in the absence of electric field and that is equal to potential energy U equal to solving we get 70 minus 20 minus 0.7 that is equal to 50 minus 0.7 is equal to 49.3